St. Vincent St. Mary High School, which, yeah, that's what I thought. Home of LeBron James, right? Yeah. Till the day I die, I will say that. And I don't care what you say, because I love LeBron, and I'm proud of it. So I went to LeBron James High School probably like 7 years after he went there. But I saw him there a lot, and we would pass in the hallways, right? He would come and visit, and I'd look up, and we'd nod at each other. And I know that he probably remembers me. I'd be walking around, and I would always feel liberated in my polo, in my khakis, right? When I went there initially, uniforms were first instated. And a lot of things would happen, right? Being a 14 or 15-year-old with big boobs, right? I'd be in the high school hallways, and I'd be like, hey, friends, Matt, how are you? Oh, you look really nice today. Can I grab your boobs? They grab them and just run. And I'd say, oh, okay. Right, because that was just part of my life there. And I would say, oh my God. And teachers in the school would say, is that a prayer or a swear? And I would say, that's a goddamn swear. PA team, which meant that I would do morning announcements with my best friend Reed, who I also lived with for a few years before this year, and we would try jokes, and we would try to like kind of spice things up, right? We would always have to say the Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, right? These prayers that would always just be part of the Catholic religion. That we would just say every day, when that was normal. There was one day before the Hoban game, which if some of you know in Akron, Hoban and St. V are huge rivals, and there would be a week-long rivalry week of festivities and decorations. We'd be like, who's the better Catholic high school? Who will win, right? I was there when we like won after 9 years and we all stormed the field and there were dogs trying to grab us and bite us and we were like, whatever, right? Like it was a big deal at the time. So the week of this Hoban week, of this, you know, we call it Wildebeest week at St. B, I was told that I had to say the Our Father. And normally I would have the prayer like written and printed in front of me and I would just read it. But this week was special. This week was about empowering the students. This week was about saying, I know what I'm doing, right? So I said, you know what? I'm not gonna look at the Our Father printed because I've been saying this for 18 years straight, so it should be fine. What happens? The morning announcements come on. We say our usual, good morning, St. VM. How are you, right? Just like the usual stuff. And Our Father comes on. And the camera pans to me, close screen, and I say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, and earth. An earth. And then I started looking around. I'm like, where's the paper? I don't remember this prayer. I've been singing for 18 years of my life. I don't remember this prayer. An earth as it is. My partner starts saying it, Reed, my friend nowadays. And then, like, I just fall. I'm just like, oh my God. Is that a prayer or a swear? Right? So I'm walking around that day, and people are like, Katie, you forgot the Our Father. Katie, what's the Our Father? Katie, can you sing that prayer again? And I had this moment where I thought, maybe I don't know what this prayer means. I don't know what this chant means. This is supposed to represent this God that I pray to. This is supposed to represent this deity, right, that I learn about every day for 45 minutes a day in religion class, right, in high school. And I could not remember it in that moment. And I don't know if it was the pressure, but I also think that part of it was like realizing that God is not a prayer or a chant, right? And now today, I don't necessarily feel comfortable with the term God, but I do think that it's an energy and it's a people, right? Like we can find positivity in each other. We can find good moments in each other. But God is not who's around you, right? It's not who you're, it's not this poem that you chant. It's not this phrase that you say, but it's something that you find in people. And in that moment of literally not remembering this chant, I realized that. That's my story.